After the Abushiri revolt ended in 1899, to prevent further rebellion, the Germans wanted to unite all of German East Africa and set some boundaries. The first order of business was to occupy the center of Tanzania and quell the angry tribes. So they started to create a road between Dar es Salaam and the inland base of Tabora. The Germans began cutting through tribes and villages, carving up the country, not caring who they affected along the way. Multiple tribes began to rise up against the Germans, notably the Chaga and the Nyamwezi, the latter of which held out against the Germans near Tabora for 2 years. But there was a certain tribe whose revolt would rise above the rest, the Hehe. After the Abushiri revolt, Emil von Zaluski was put in charge of the Schutztruppe and army of German East Africa. Julius von Soden was, at the time, governor of German East Africa. Throughout the beginning of 1891, Chief Mkwawa, leader of the Hehe, started harassing Germans throughout the interior of Tanzania with his warriors. So in August, Julius von Soden sent Emil von Zaluski, along with a little over a dozen European officers, and over 300 Schutztruppe Askari troops, all of whom were black, up to the Hehe capital, Iringa, to defeat what they thought was a small number of Hehe warriors and establish control over the tribe. Horses died from disease in Tanzania, and donkeys were still in short supply. So a little under 200 porters were enlisted from nearby towns to carry the troops' things. This group of nearly 530 men marched up into the savannah on August 17th, with Emil von Zaluski at the front of the column on one of the few donkeys they had. When the column arrived at Lugalo, a small village outside Iringa, they found it largely uninhabited. Unbeknownst to them, over 2,500 Hehe warriors, led by Chief Mkwawa's brother, were hidden in the bush surrounding the trail they were walking down. When the column started moving again, the Hehe charged out, enveloping the column from three sides. Only the rear guard, saved by the quick thinking of Lieutenant Tettenborn, was able to survive. Zaluski was stabbed in the chest by a Hehe warrior and killed. The rear guard managed to escape, but almost all of the rest of the column was chopped. Only 4 Europeans, 65 Askari, and a little over 70 porters survived. Less than a third of the column that started. That's not to say the Hehe suffered no casualties. They possibly suffered upwards of 500 dead. But it was still a devastating battle for the Germans. The rest of the column retreated back to Dar es Salaam. The Schutztruppe was in tatters, and the Hehe controlled the roads in the center of Tanzania, raiding convoys and robbing travelers. But 2 years later, in 1893, von Soden left and Colonel Friedrich von Schiel took power as governor. He decided to take out the Hehe once and for all, and in the fall of 1894, Tom von Prince was sent with nearly 1,000 men and a few machine guns to Iringa to take out the Hehe. After taking the Hehe defensive positions at Lugalo and Kalenga, the column moved into Iringa itself. Mkwawa fled and the Hehe were massacred trying to charge the machine guns. For the next 4 years, Mkwawa recruited men from tribes all over and led a guerrilla campaign against the Germans, poking out with surprise attacks on columns of soldiers and caravans. By 1896, some of the Hehe decided to submit to the Germans, and by early 1898, there were few attacks. The Germans tracked down the last Hehe rebels and took them out, and surrounded Mkwawa and his best men at his house. There, in July, to avoid capture by the Germans, Mkwawa shot himself, and the Hehe rebellion was over.